Welcome friends to this session. In this session, we'll be discussing about one of the important topic in computer science, and that is being called as an artificial intelligence. Knowingly or unknowingly, you will find that many of us are now practicing artificial intelligence in our daily lives. In this session, we will understand what we mean by artificial intelligence and how artificial intelligence can be used in the education. Maybe the future of education can be predicted through this session. As we know that you are observing or you are viewing this session on my YouTube channel, Learn with Prakash Kanani. Now let us understand what is artificial intelligence or AI. We all know that the human beings are intelligent, and the human intelligence is being known as a natural intelligence. Artificial intelligence, you can say that, is a machine intelligence. Our computer machines are the digital machines, and they are not intelligent. But it is possible to write some algorithms through which we can make them intelligent. And they behave to just like human beings. And such intelligence is being called as an artificial intelligence. So broadly, you can say that AI or artificial intelligence is an area of computer science where we can create the intelligent machines, that is the computer machines or other devices that works like or react like to that of human beings. You will find that several examples can be given of artificial intelligence. For example, whenever we see an automated car driving, that is a car without a driver, or when we find that the speech is being automatically recognized, or image is being recognized automatically, or face is recognized automatically, then you can say that the programs must be making the use of artificial intelligence. So artificial intelligence, you can say, is a task where the computer can perform or can behave to just like of human beings. You will find that currently computer is not in a position to perform any task just like human beings, because when the complexity of the task increases, then the human beings are more suitable to perform such tasks. Let us understand some few examples. Say for example, I ask you to sum the numbers from 1 to 10 to the power 12. You will find that this is a very huge sum, but it is not complex. It is an easy sum. But for computer also, you will find that a simple program can be written where a computer can easily perform such addition. But if you ask any human being to do this summation, then you will find that for him it will be difficult, because a lot of time will be required, and you will find that he may encounter certain errors when performing such repetitive addition. But this is a task where you will find that no artificial intelligence will be required. Now let us consider another example. Say for example, you have been given thousands of MCQ answer sheets, and you have been asked to grade these answer sheets. You will find that this is not a complex task. It is a simple task, and for a computer it is a very easy task. By writing a simple program, a computer can easily check such MCQ answer sheets. But if you ask a human being to check these answer sheets, then probably you will find that it is very difficult for him, because a lot of time will be required, and as a human being he may encounter certain errors. But in this task also, you will observe that no AI will be required. Now let us consider another example. Suppose an word essay is being given to you, and suppose the word essay contains more than 10,000 words, and suppose this is a essay written on some Arch and Narayan's work, or you can consider any PhD thesis is being given for the evaluation. This is a very complex task. It is very difficult for a computer to perform, but it is not that much difficult, isn't it? Because a human expert can easily do such task, but of course some time will be required. Now this is a task where you can say that the artificial intelligence is required. Now suppose if it is needed that more than 500 essays or more than 500 theses are to be evaluated or to be graded, then you will find that this is a very huge task, and even for humans it is very difficult to get it done. You will find that knowingly or unknowingly we are making the use of artificial intelligence in our daily life. Most of us make the use of it. For example, whenever you use some voice command on your phone, then you will find that actually what you are doing is that you are making the use of AI algorithm. These programs are run on the server and they are on the cloud, and therefore you will find that whenever we give some command like this, then they require the internet connectivity. Another example can be given of Google Translate. You will find that the Google will translate the text written or any speech from one language to another language. Then this Google Translate is not a simple dictionary operation, but it will require an artificial intelligence. Many times you will find that your face image is being typed in many different images. So such tagging of the image requires artificial intelligence. You will find that your phone recognizes your facial image, or your facial image can be recognized in many other images also. So such recognition will also require the artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence is a technology. Basically, it is a software, or you can say that it is a collection of algorithms. There are different forms of AI in existence today. Some of these forms we will discuss in this session. Say, for example, we have a form that is being called as a machine learning. Machine learning, you can say, is a kind of a computer algorithm that will learn from the data so that its performance can be improved automatically. One common example that can be given for machine learning is the email spam or malware filter. Everybody of us making use of email, and you will find that there are a lot of unwanted emails coming to your inbox. Now these emails can be easily filtered out by using such software, and you can say that this software is an example of this machine learning. You will find that the neural network is another technology. Neural network is just like that of the human brain. Human brain is a collection of neurons. So artificially it is possible to construct such network. And this network can be used to identify the relationship among the data. Several examples can be given where the neural network can be used. For example, if somebody write an algorithm for the stock market prediction, then this can be an example where the neural network technology is being used. Another technology in the AI is called as the deep learning. Deep learning, you can say, is a part of the machine learning. You can say that it is a more higher level form of the learning, where the algorithm themselves can take the decision as that of the human beings. A common example that can be given for the deep learning is the automated driving algorithm. So on television, sometimes we observe that some companies been testing the automatic driving. So driver is not there and still the car is running from one destination to another destination. So where to stop, where to start, where to reach, all such decisions will be taken by the machine itself. And you can say that such machine will be making the use of deep learning algorithms. Natural language processing is another area where the AI is being used. You will find that the language that is being used by the humans is being called as a natural language. And many times we communicate with each other by using this natural language. As a human being, we can understand this language, but computers are not in a position to understand these languages. But it is possible to write the algorithms, and by using these algorithms, you will find that the machines such as computer can also understand such languages. A common example can be given for the natural language processing is the Google Assistant. That is being commonly used. Whenever you say anything to the Google Assistant, you make the use of English language, and this Google Assistant can easily understand certain words that you are saying to him, and you work accordingly. You will find that the artificial intelligence technology can be used in education also, and such technology is being called as AI8, that is artificial intelligence in education. You will find that here we will discuss some of the issues where the artificial intelligence can be used. So for example, if you want to develop a smart content, the content which is dynamic in nature, the content that can change as per the user, such content development is possible by making the use of artificial intelligence. It is possible to develop the intelligent tutorial system where the customized teaching is possible. The virtual environment learning is possible with the help of the AI. That is, suppose a medical student is performing some operation. So without actually performing any operation, because when a student perform an operation, there is a lot of risk involved in. So without actually performing the operation digitally or virtually, he can perform the operation and can learn many more new things. You will find that a lot of student data can be collected, and this data can be used for many useful predictions. Say for example, a student performance in a course can be easily predicted by using the intelligent mining. The student performance can be improved by using the intelligent mining. And hence we can say that the learning modes can be customized, the admissions can be customized, or the learning pathways can be customized. So we definitely have advantages when we use artificial intelligence in education. The course selection will be much easier when we use the AI technology. The learning will become a joy because the content will be a smart content. It will be a dynamic content and it will change as per the student. And therefore, the learning will be a joy for a student. You will find that the learning progress, the data related with the learning progress will be easily and quickly accessible to the parents, to the teachers, and to the student himself. Practically, you will find that the creativity and curiosity is not possible to measure. But with AI, it may be possible for us to measure the creativity and curiosity of a student. And in future, you will find that the future of the student will mostly depend upon these two parameters. I think that in near future, it is not possible to completely replace the human teacher. But with AI, isn't it? Our AI tools will be a kind of assistantship to the human teachers. So you can say that with AI, it is possible that the gap between the teaching and learning is reduced. So we may get some new insights, which otherwise are very difficult in traditional assessment. For example, in traditional assessment, we can only judge whether a student has given a correct answer or not. But with AI, it may be possible for a teacher to understand how the learner have arrived at an answer. Means he can see digitally that how, what is the thinking process or what is the thought process that is being involved while arriving at the answer by the student. So I think in the coming future, there are strong chances that the artificial intelligence may be used in education. And if it is to be used in the education, then it is really going to help us a lot. Thank you, friends, for observing this presentation. And if you want to share with some comments, then always you can share your comments with me and you can write to me for any improvement. Thank you all for observing this presentation.